This is a D5 fridge. It's got a LCD display. There's a water dispenser. I've taken all the panels off. In the bottom, there's a little evaporator coil with a fan motor and a heating element. And in the top of the fridge, there is an internal cold plate. There's a little sensing device. This is the cover I've taken off. It's got a little computer fan motor on it. This cover fits inside here. And at the bottom, it's got this cover here, which has just got a little grid with a fan motor. And this cover fits in the bottom here. Now this fridge, when it runs, the compressor runs, it gets cold, the fan turns and everything. But this defrost element never comes on. This coil just ices up all the time. I've put direct 220 onto the element, and the element does work. This is a little safety device, a micro temp that will switch the element on if it gets too hot. There's the two wires for the fan, and there is a little sensor down there. Now, this whole lot is controlled by, it looks like two PC boards on top of the roof. I've emptied it now. There's one little PC board, and there's the second one. Now, I'm sure if I try hard enough, I'll be able to get these PC boards. But I'm not interested. I'm not even going to try. What I did figure out, this plug here, the blue and the brown, is your 220. If I bridge the, like I put a little bridge piece in there, the brown wire to the yellow, the elements comes on. And if I bridge the brown to the black wire, then the compressor and the fan motor runs. So that function I'm going to do with a defrost timer. And then inside this fridge, there's obviously some sort of sensor, or this must be the sensor that senses the temperature. But what I've done is I've made a little hole on the top there. You can just take this cover out the way. And this is one of my welding rods. And I stuck it all the way through, and it comes out on the roof. There it comes out. So I'm going to stick a thermostat bulb down here, and just with foil tape stick it onto the cold plate. I'll put a thermostat up here and a defrost timer, but I'll keep these two components here, because inside the fridge, I mean on the outside here, they've got this display, and it's got LED lights that shine very nicely, that work off that board, and it works through this switch here. So that I'm going to carry on using, but I'm going to put a thermostat and a timer in here. And then at the bottom, I've done a few of these. This little red device here, I'll just replace it with a defrost termination switch. So it's going to go on defrost every 8 hours, whether there's ice or not. And if there's no ice, the defrost termination switch will switch the element off. There's the thermostat bulb, comes out through the hole. It was a bit long, so I made a coil in and I stuck it on there with a piece of aluminium foil tape. I normally take a bit of care and stick it on straight. This one doesn't look nice, but it's on there, it will never come off. And there's a cover that's going to cover this, so you won't see that. I normally tell people the pieces people can't see, do it very neat, but I'm not following my own recipe now, I'm doing it ugly, but the idea is there. This is stuck on, it will, this freezes until the thermostat will pick the temperature up from there. And then what I've done on top here, I've connected a little defrost timer on the brown and blue wire that goes to the PC board. This brown and blue, I've just spliced it in there. It's on now, and there's a little window. If your eyes are better than mine, you'll see a little flywheel spinning in there. So what I'm going to do now is the yellow and black wire, yellow being the defrost, I'll connect onto contact one, and the black wire onto number two for the compressor. But black wire will go through the thermostat, which comes out there. So when the thermostat cycles, the compressor and the fan stops. There's one other thing I noticed on this fridge. The fan motor that's in the fridge is this one here, and it's not 220 volt, it's a low voltage. So this obviously works off the PC board as well. I'll first put it in the way it is, because this PC board still functions, it just doesn't go on defrost. Maybe the fan turns. If not, I'll either replace that with a 220 volt fan, or I'll see if I can put a little power supply in here to run the fan motor, but I'll get to that later. The fridge is running now. I've connected the timer, the yellow wire being the defrost, and the black wire, or this brown wire, goes to the thermostat. I connected it onto the thermostat contact 3 and 6 is your, but the fan wasn't running, so then I realized this gray wire is your fan, black wire being compressor. So I've just doubled them up on the same connection there. So now the fridge is running, compressor started up, it's getting cold, and the fan is turning. So what I'm going to do is, normally when you do something like this, just test it before you run it for too long. So what I'm going to do is turn this timer, I'll just turn it by hand onto defrost. It will make a distinct clicking sound when it goes on defrost, and then I'll just feel if the elements get hot and the fan and the compressor must stop. I'll just do that for testing purposes, and then later on I'll put the defrost termination switch in. Timer's on defrost, the fan stopped, the compressor stopped, and if I put my hand onto the little drain element, I can feel the heat there. There's heat there. So this little device here I'm going to replace with a defrost termination switch. I've opened it up to see what is inside this little box, and there's two little bimetal switches in, which looks really cheap and nasty. There's two brown wires and two blue wires. So there's two separate ones, so the two blue wires is on the one switch and the two brown wires on the other switch. So I just bypass one of them and put the termination switch across the other one. This little device just pulls out here. There it is, so I can put it on the workbench and put the defrost termination switch in. What I've done now with this defrost termination switch, the orange and the yellow wire, I've connected it onto the two blues, soldered it on, and I've just bypassed the brown, and there's a piece of heat shrink, so I'm just going to slide it over, crimp it, and heat it up, and it will make it a waterproof seal. Fridge got cold very quick. This is about 40 minutes, 2.3 degrees in the fridge. This cover here, I've just put it back temporary, I just pushed it in, and this little low voltage fan is spinning its heart out, so that works very well. So I'll leave it as it is. I'm sure on the electronic board there's times when it switches off, but it can carry on doing that. Here's the thermostat, I've put a knob on, and we just rotate on the knob, and there it cycles about a half a turn. So on the thermostat here it will maintain temperature, on the timer it will do the defrost. So the rest of the board is all connected, and the only reason for the rest of the board is this display in the door. If you push these buttons, it even plays music, and it shows you what temperature, and the button goes up and down, and it does lots of things. So that's nice, people like that. And these LED lights, if you open this cover, you'll see inside there's lots of electronics in there. So the PC board has got a function for that. I've finished with this fridge now. There's the two thermometers in the compressor cycled at the moment, 3.9 and -14.4. And if you open the door, there's all the covers in all together, light is working. I put a little screw on each side because the clips at the bottom were broken, and in the bottom it's all together. There's still a screw lying here. It works nicely, it functions well, the display works. So from the outside you won't notice anything different, and whoever gets this fridge might even adjust the temperature on this display board, which is actually going to do nothing. This is nice, it's got a water dispenser as well. The only thing is, if you look on the roof,